brilliant.
And Umpire Henderson has called him for throwing.
You haven't believed it? That's a disappointing finish.
Ridiculous the far.
As per MCC Law No. 21, a no-ball in cricket is a type of illegal delivery to a batter and also a type of extra, being the run awarded to the batting team. A no-ball shall not count as one of the over. When no-ball has been called, neither batter shall be out under any of the laws except Law 34 of hit the ball twice, 37 of obstructing the field, or 38 of run out. In limited overs cricket, a batter also receives a free hit on the ball after any no-ball, which means the batter can freely hit that one ball with no danger of being out in most ways except the same, Law No. 34, 37 or 38. If a ball qualifies as a no-ball and a white 2, it is a no-ball. The umpire calls a no-ball in the following 11 situations. The umpire shall make sure whether the bowler intends to bowl right-handed or left-handed, over or around the wicket, and shall so inform the striker. It is unfair if the bowler fails to notify the umpire of a change in his mode of delivery. In this case, the umpire shall call and signal no ball. The bowler's front foot must land with some part of the foot behind the popping crease, whether grounded or raised. The crease refers to the inside edge of the painted line, not the line itself. If the foot lands on or beyond the crease, it is a no ball. If the front foot of a bowler lands behind the crease and slides beyond, then it is not a no ball. The bowler's front foot must also land whether grounded or raised, with some part of the foot on the same side of the imaginary line joining the two middle stumps as the back foot. The bowler's back foot must land within and not touch the return piece before the landing of the front foot. Any part of the back foot can legally be in the air outside of the crease, and it can even be grounded but only after front foot landing. After the bowler has entered his delivery stride, if in the opinion of either umpire the ball has been thrown or delivered underarm, the umpire shall call and signal no ball. However, the bowler may bowl underarm if this style of delivery is agreed upon before the match. If you want to understand more about illegal deliveries and the laws of throwing or chucking, you can watch this video. The umpire shall call and signal no ball if either a ball bounces more than once or rolls along the ground before it reaches the popping crease, or pitches wholly or partially off the pitch that is 10 feet in width as defined in Law No. 6 before it reaches the line of the striker's wicket. If a ball delivered by the bowler comes to rest in front of the line of the striker's wicket or is so far from the pitch that the striker would need to leave the pitch to attempt to play the ball, the umpire shall call and signal no ball. If the bowler breaks the wicket at any time after the ball comes into play and before completion of the stride, this shall include any clothing or other object that falls from his person and breaks the wicket. As per Law 27, if the wicketkeeper moves any part of his person in front of the line of the stumps before either the ball strikes the batter's person or bat, or the ball passes the line of the stumps. As per Law 28, if there are more than two fielders on the leg side behind the popping crease other than the wicketkeeper, the strikers and umpire shall call and signal no ball. In limited overs cricket, there cannot be more than five fielders on the onside and outside the 30-yard circle. As per Laws 21 and 28, while the ball is in play and until the ball has made contact with the striker's bat or person or has passed the striker's wicket, no fielder other than the bowler must have any part of his person neither grounded on or extended over the pitch nor making contact with the ball delivered by the bowler. According to Law No. 41, any ball that bounces between shoulder and head height is called as the first bouncer by the umpire. Any ball that bounces over head height is a white ball as well as the first bouncer. But a second bouncer in an over in T20I or third bouncer in ODI and Test cricket is called a no ball. According to Law No. 41, any delivery that passes or would have passed without pitching above the waist height of the striker standing upright at the popping crease is unfair. For deliberate beamers and overstepping, the umpire shall direct the captain of the fielding side to suspend the bowler immediately from bowling. For other dangerous and unfair no-balls or for throwing, the bowler may be suspended as well as required to undertake remedial work on their bowling action. An umpire shall revoke the call of no-ball if a dead ball is called under any of the clauses of Law No. 20. Now click on this video if you want to know all the 10 ways how a batter can be dismissed in cricket.